A long time ago, all the fish had very symmetrical noses, just like this. They came to a wonderful, beautiful point. Their noses were just built to go through that water, just cut that water. And now you notice that some of them have a big hook on their nose. There's the king that has a hook on his nose. And fact is, as they get older, most of them develop that. The males do. But it all started a long time ago with a chum. Comes in late in the fishing season. In fact, it's coming in now, probably started in August. Start running the rivers. And they, too, had very beautiful, very symmetrical bodies. They would cut through the water for their long swim out to sea and to come back again. This female was coming back, and you could tell that she had many eggs in her tummy. Her tummy was getting kind of round like that. And her friend was right there with her. Her partner was protecting her all the way, just ahead of her, so that he could break the water, so that she could conserve some of her energy for having and developing all those eggs that were within her body. And as they came down towards the Straits of Juan de Fuca, they made that corner, and she started sniffing for her river. And he would say, "Is this your river?" When they went by the sea, you know, that's not my river. And oh my, she was getting tired. "And is this your river?" "No, that's not my river. That was Klallam Bay." "No, that's not it." And they kept swimming and swimming. And then finally they got down the Elwha River. "No, that wasn't it either." "Nope." And then they went to Morris Creek. "Nope, that wasn't it." Oh, my, you could just about see her tummy getting bigger and bigger from all these little eggs that were just developing in her body. Finally, she got down to the Dungeness River, and she said, "This is it. This is it." And oh, my, she became just like she got a burst of energy. "This is it. This is it." And so they both turned there, and they went back along the spit to go to the mouth of the Dungeness. And they started swimming up there. And oh my, she was getting tired. Yes, she was getting tired now. And she says, "I need some rest. I need some rest." "Oh, fine. Okay," he says to her. And then he found this deep, deep hole, you know, a place where the water slowed and it kind of swirled, and it was just a good place to rest. And so they went over there with the idea of staying all night. And indeed, you know, they did rest and sleep. Did you know, by the way, that fish do not have eyelids? But they do have a film that comes down, you know, and it covers their eyelids. But you can't tell, they might be asleep. Just a protective coating. Anyway, the next morning they woke up and they were way down at the mouth of the river again. And now her tummy, you could just see, look at it. Look at it. It's getting bigger and bigger. And she says, "Oh, no, what happened?" And they drifted without knowing it all the way back down that river. That was one time. So, my, I don't know whether I can make this again. And so they started swimming back, and they swam. Sure enough, they passed the place that they had been, and they had to get further on up the river. And then she says, "I'm getting tired again. I need to get rest." And it was getting darker, too. And again, the same thing happened. He thought he had it figured out so that she could stay in one place all night, and then they could just make that short trip up to the nest. But no, they woke up, and they're all the way down at the mouth. "Oh, my," she says, "I don't know if I can make it. That's just so far, and look at me, and now her tummy was really big." Oh, now he was really getting kind of frightened about this. He says, I'll make sure that this does not happen again. I will promise I'll make sure this will not happen again. And so they took off swimming. And so she just knew that he was going to do the right thing this time. And so she says, I'm getting tired again. It was getting near sunset. And she says, I'm getting tired. I need to rest. She says, my tummy is getting so uncomfortable. And so he says, well, can you make it just around to that corner? He says, I know that there's a low-lying limb right up there. And she says, yes, I can make it that far. But why do you want to go there? He says, well, I have this plan. He says, I'm going to go over and I'm going to grab that low-lying branch with my mouth. When I do that, you go back and you grab a hold of my tail with your mouth. And then all night long, we will swim and float as I'm holding on to this branch. And then we will stay there all night long because I'm going to hold on real tight. Okay. And so that's what they did. And they just floated and floated, and, you know, went back and forth and up and down. And he held on so tight with his mouth around that low-lying branch. The next morning they woke up, and yes, indeed, they were right there. They were right there, just as he said that he would do. He promised, and it came true. Now all she had to do was just let go of his tail. She was free, and she could go on ahead of him and lay her eggs in the nest, and then he would follow her there. And that's what she did. She let go of his tail and swam, but she did look over her shoulder, and she thought, my, he looks different. He looks different. But she didn't have time to wait to decide why he looked different. He just did look different. And so she swam, kept going till she got to the nest and laid all her eggs, and then here he comes. My, he really does look different. Then she understood. From him holding on to that low-lying branch, holding his weight, her coming up and holding on to his tail, and there was her weight. It changed the form of his tail, his nose. Now his nose had formed a hook on it, the same size as that branch. And from then to this day, the salmon has a hook on his nose. And now you know how it got there.